Okay. I'm watching Molly and Andra over here on Molly Golightly's channel. And the title, you can see it right there, is Summer Whales and the Fake News Circus. Just in case if you want to go and watch their whole video in full, because I want to play just a very small tidbit of it, just because I want to give you my thoughts on this one little part. And I know that Molly strikes people like all the time, so I really hope she wouldn't strike me for just giving my thoughts. I mean, that would be a bit ridiculous. But if she does, you know, I'm a very small channel. I don't even have 1,000 subscribers. I'm not monetized. So she really can't do me much damage anyway, right? So anyway, and I did tell you whose content this is, where to find it, and I will link her video in the description to give her credit for her content. So I'm just going to play for just a few seconds. I want you to listen to what Andra's saying, or Andra, Bullhorn Betty. Listen to what she's saying just for a minute, or a few seconds. And then I just have a comment about it that I just wanted to say. Okay? All right. Listen, just for a second. Now, actually, let me tell you what she's talking about real fast. She is talking about Brian Laundrie and his parents. She's talking about Brian Laundrie's parents finding his body. Okay? Now, listen.
Up that Mustang. I think they went out and looked for Brian. I think that they found him. And I think they quietly took the car home. And that's why they decided to lock.
Okay, listen. She's talking about the day that they went and got the Mustang from the reserve. This is the day she's speaking of. Okay, she thinks that the day they went and got the Mustang, that they actually found Brian that day. So keep listening for a few more seconds.
Themselves in the house for a month. I think they were truly mourning their son's loss, and they just thought law enforcement would eventually find him. And 5 weeks later, all the protests later, and then a lawsuit showing him jumping across the lawn, and, you know, a man that's never been sued by anybody in his life. They knew that, you know, to me, I honestly believe, you know, now looking at retrospect, hindsight's 2020, I really believe that day that they went and picked up that Mustang, I think they went out and looked for Brian. I think that they found him. And I think they quietly took the car home. And that's why they decided to lock themselves in the house for a month. I think they were truly mourning their son's loss. And they just thought law enforcement would eventually find him. And 5 weeks later, all the protests later. And
that is absolutely the most outlandish and ridiculous thing in the world I think I've ever heard. So I played that back for you a second time. So Andra says that she really believes that on the day that Brian's parents went and picked up the Mustang, that they found Brian's body. They found him dead, and they left him there and went back home. Left their dead son out in the reserve for all the animals to eat on, you know, to get rained on. Get blowed away if a storm came. Whatever, you know. And they went back home for a whole month knowing their son was laying out there in the reserve dead. They did that, according to Andra and her opinion, instead of laying their son to rest properly, like most parents that I know of would do. So, you know, I mean, I do watch Molly, and I do watch Andra and Olivia and Josh and and I'm good with all them. I enjoy their content. I do appreciate what they're doing. I hope they help find Summer or some information. You know, I have no problem with these people. But the hat was the most outlandish theory I've heard anybody say. And I couldn't keep quiet. I had to say something about it. What do y'all think? Tell me. I want to know. Am I the crazy one here? Or what do y'all believe? Do y'all believe that Brian Laundrie's parents, on the day that they went and picked that Mustang up, do you think they found his body dead and left him there for a whole month to wait for law enforcement to find him? Or do you think that if that had been the case, they would have probably called 911 and reported it and then, you know, gotten their son's body and been allowed to give him a proper funeral? I mean, isn't that what most people would have done? I don't know. That's what I would have done. No way would I leave my kid laid out somewhere, dead or alive. I don't care. No. Who does that? And who in the world thinks stuff like that? That's insane. So let me know what you think. I'm curious.